Hello friends, welcome to my super learning channel. Today I am going to show you how to create a drop down list in the Excel spreadsheet and how to apply various input validations around it. For this I am going to use WPS Office package, which is similar to Microsoft Excel, but pretty much the functionality remains same. Let's get started. For the demonstration purpose, I am creating a few zones. This is my data. If you go to the data menu, you will see there is an option called validation, and within this validation, I will choose the validation criteria as list. So there are several other validation types available. To create a drop down, we need to choose the list, and then I need to select the source values. So what values that drop down will be holding. I am leaving the zone and just picking the values that I want to list. They are in my combo box. Okay, so you can see the combo box is created. It's very simple now. It has north, east, west, and south, all the four values that I selected. Now we will go on little bit. Enhance this validation. I am going to uncheck this ignore blank. So when I do this, this drop down becomes mandatory and user cannot skip it without selecting the value. And input message. So if I want to show something as an input message, when mouse hovers on this particular field, select the zone. And I can similarly create a error alert as well when user doesn't select a proper value. Giving the similar title. And here I will make it as insert drop down. So I will remove this drop down option. So that it becomes a free form text, but still the user can only enter the relevant values. See, immediately when I just come and visit to this particular cell, it is showing me the input validation message, and I type some random value, immediately it shows the error pop up. This message clearly indicates me that I have to select a proper value. And one thing you can also notice, like as I start typing, it gives me the autocomplete feature of the available listed values. As soon as I started typing W, to showing me rest is the possible value that I can select. And if I don't want to have this as a free form text and the user have to go and select the value from a drop down, then I need to check this in cell drop down. Now this becomes a drop down field. User can go and click the values from here. And if I want to apply this to remaining cells, I just need to copy paste. Automatically the formula gets applied. All the validations gets applied to the relevant fields. And normally people go on hide this column because it doesn't appear. The screen. Let me unhide this for now. And there is another option where you can get the same feature called insert drop down list, which is available next to the validation. Here, either I can have these values added manually. This is an advanced feature available with WPS Office. Instead of storing that in a spreadsheet, you can add this to this feature so that it resides somewhere as a global parameter. You can pick this value. But even I can go on the pick, go and select the values from the existing range, which we have done already in the previous example. So both works. Similarly, and the validation has a lot of other features, like you can give the validation messages during the input, as well as if you want to give an error alert. And one more thing I want to emphasize here is there is a style option which is showing the up to three values. Stop means you cannot pass this field without entering a proper value. At times you just want to show some warning, but you want the user to continue working on this field without giving a proper value, still you can go for warning. This will show a warning, but user will not be restricted to fill in the value. And information is something similar. It is just used for the informational purpose. So you are not going to prompt anything, but you just show some information to the user. But in this particular case, stop or warning makes more sense. And there is another checkbox called apply these changes to all other cells in the same setting. So you are making a change to one drop down, and if you want to apply this to all other drop downs, you don't need to copy paste the same values to other drop downs. Instead, you can just check this and it will be automatically applied to the remaining drop downs. You see, the validations are shown here. I hope you enjoyed this video. play around and you can learn a lot and you can find a practical way how you can use this drop down list and make use of this wonderful feature in your work. Thanks friends. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Also, please like, share and comment. Thank you.